cornbread.
Good evening, fellow pupils. This is my question. Are subliminal messages intentional or retrospective? Trick for mine. We'll go on to the next slide. So first of all, what are subliminal messages? Subliminal messages are forms of messages which escape our conscious perception, but reach through to the brain unconsciously. The most normal examples of subliminal messages are visually or by audio. This is an iceberg. This shows your conscious mind, and then your subconscious. All meaningful decisions are made from the subconscious level. The history behind subliminal messages. James Vickery claimed to have introduced subliminal messages with big advertising effects in 1957 when he conducted an experiment with very quickly flashing messages in the movies of cinema in New Jersey, which were subliminal messages. People thought it worked that well when they certainly using it for political persuasion, which gave room to conspiracy theories. The government, or by communism, was using subliminal seduction to persuade people or use mind control. And that is James Vickery. This is the images used to flash in the cinemas. So the message protection phrases like drink Coca-Cola, or hungry, eat popcorn. It was displayed so fast that people never consciously could notice them. These of the messages performed in advertisements increased popcorn and cola sales by 67%, so it's a significant increase in it. Anyway. So it shows that subliminal messages work. How are subliminal messages embedded in music? In everyday life, it has a widespread belief that word messages can be embedded and into music with the intention of manipulating listeners' behaviour. Many have claimed that subliminal techniques are used for advertising and propaganda purposes, for example in the movie Josie and the Pussycats. Success of bands is based on subliminal advertising messages weaved into songs by the band's producers. This is an audio example of subliminal messages in music.
Thank you.
so that's my clip. With a very good ending, saying, do you think spam messages are intentional? So.
It's turning the volume off. Right, it's there on the speaker.
In my opinion, I think the majority of spam messages are intentional, with few being coincidental. I think that because I have a lot of evidence behind me proving that they exist, but on the other hand, I want my audience to decide if they are intentional or accidental. So, guys, do you think they are intentional or accidental?
Why is there a picture of candy?
Please, can you explain? Is it intentional? Do you reckon intentional?
Yeah.
Okay. Mm-hmm. So that's my presentation. Thank you. Good night.